Welcome to C Prompt, your prompts as a service platform that turns your AI prompts into service for your target audience, community, or market. My name is Kibir. In this video, I will show you a simple example of how to turn a ChatGPT prompt into a web app using the C Prompt platform. So let's get started. The very first step is to identify a problem worth solving using AI. So problems that require content creation are very suitable for LLM like ChatGPT. In this video, I want to create a prompt app using a ChatGPT prompt to give my target audience a weekly exercise plan. Let's go to the next step. We need to engineer the prompt. We need to write the prompt, test the prompt, and refine it so that we have a prompt that produces the right type of output that we are looking for. Now that we are on ChatGPT, I'm going to paste the prompt that I prepared for this project. So here's the prompt that I wrote. Create a weekly exercise program suitable for a 52-year-old male in Rockland, California to focus on strength training using mostly outdoor activities and limit activities to 60 minutes, preferably in the evening due to typical summer weather conditions. Start the week on Sunday and avoid using any external tools or devices. Also, instead of the word repetitions, use shorthand reps. So now if I run that, I get a weekly plan from ChatGPT. And I have reviewed this prompt a few times, so I'm happy with the prompt. I'm ready to go to C Prompt and build the app using this prompt so that people who are using the app don't need to know about ChatGPT or how to create a prompt. Now that we have figured out what our prompt looks like, we need to create the actual prompt app on C Prompt AI. Let's go do that. To create the prompt app, we go to C Prompt AI, sign in, click on I want to create a prompt. There is a button called create a prompt app, or I can click on the menu, click the new prompt app. This is the prompt app editor. This allows you to turn a ChatGPT prompt into a web-based prompt app, and this app can be used by any user on the internet without the knowledge of AI, and they don't have to interact with ChatGPT. They just work with your prompt app. Simple and easy to do. In this editor, first thing we're going to select is the category. We're going to post our prompt into health category under fitness. These are already populated for you. Now we're going to give it a title. We're going to call it custom weekly exercise program for you. Now we're going to need a description. So let's write a simple description. I'm going to paste the prompt that we already created on ChatGPT. Remember, this prompt is specific to a specific age, specific location. We're going to change all that. This is where we customize the prompt so that it becomes useful by other people who have different age, different location, different needs. First, we're going to customize the age. So here is the hard-coded 52-year-old. We're going to select that. Then we're going to click on field option. This will show us a list of available fields in the system. These are the most common field used. That age is already there, so I can use that. I could have created a custom field as well. Since we already have an existing field called age, I'm going to apply that. This drops a little tag called age. This is the tag that'll turn into a question for the user. Now we're going to also want to change the genders. Go to the list option and see if we have an existing list called gender. I see a gender right there, a list. These are the available lists. The little lock shows that these are system provided lists, so we cannot edit them, but we can also build our own list. In this example, I'm not going to build it. I'm just going to show you a simple example of applying a list. So now we have applied the age and the gender list. Now we will select the Rockland, California part, which is the location, and we'll replace it with a field called location. Now, do we have a field called location? No. Let's go ahead and create a new field. So in this case, we can enter our new label, enter location, and then name the field location, placeholder Sacramento, California. So I'm going to apply that. So now we dropped in that as well. We are saying that focus on strength training. The user may not want strength training, so we're going to select that and see if we have a list of available exercise type. We actually do type of exercise, so we're going to apply specify that. Again, we could have created a list as well. So now we have age. So we're talking about suitable for a 52-year-old, and we need to type in the age will be a number. So we'll type in 52 years old, male or female in Sacramento, California, whatever this enter, focusing on what type of exercise, using mostly outdoor. Let's leave that alone. Let's go ahead and enter a new field. This time we're going to enter a custom field. We're going to call it how long in minute. Let's just give them a clue that is in minutes, then minutes. We'll put that in. What about starting in the weekday on Sunday? So we're going to select a list weekday, and we'll drop that down so people can choose which day they want to start their exercise program. Everything else we can leave them alone. So this is good. Before we save it, we need to choose what type of prompt it is. So let's make it private for now and then save as draft. Now if you click on view, it's going to show you what we have created. So you can see right there that we are able to select gender. These are the gender options. We're able to select the type of exercise. We're able to select the day of the week. So that's the prompt customization. This is what our platform does. Our platform is allowing the user who is using the prompt to enter this information and get AI response without knowing anything about how to do this. So this is what the power of this platform is. And this is, again, very simple stuff. You can do a lot more. As you can see, we have many, many options. And in this video, I'm not going to go over all that. The next step is to test our prompt app. So we can click on run and come here where user will see the prompt. So now let's go ahead and test run this. So we'll enter male, we'll select exercise program cardiovascular, we'll select, let's start on Monday. Let's say the age is 35, and how long do we want to exercise? Let's say 120 minutes. So as you can see, this information that I've entered all got plugged into this prompt, and now this prompt is ready to run. You can choose how big the response we want it. So let's go ahead and choose 1,000 words. Very conservative is fine, but we can go balanced. These are the levels of creativity that we are allowing the AI to do. We're going to click on run, and this is going to run the prompt and generate the response. And this takes time because AI is not a database query. So here is the response that came in, and we have some sample response right here. The best way to look at it is to look at the PDF. So let's go ahead and click on the PDF button, and here it is. So you can see that the exercise program has been created. Let me make that bigger. Weekly exercise program for a 35-year-old male in Queens, New York. Very nice. What should be done on Monday? What should be done on Tuesday, Wednesday, and so on and so on. So every day, and then more details. All this is nicely produced. This is what the user who will be using this prompt we'll see. They don't have to know it's AI. This is what we do. We simplify prompt engineering so that you can end up with a prompt app. Once you have created the app and test run the app, all your test runs would become available. If you refresh this page, you will see a history being generated. We ran it just a minute ago, and we can view the previous results. So you can actually go back as you are tweaking the prompt. You can always go back and see different results. Sometimes when you tweak it too much, you may lose something. So you can go back and see the results. Now we also version control this automatically, but in this beta we're not letting you access the older version of the prompt. In the future we'll allow you to access older version of the prompt so you can go back and forth. If you make a mistake and tweak it too much and it doesn't do what you want, you can always go back to older version. So now that we have saved the prompt, test run the prompt, we need to go ahead and publish the prompt. So we click on edit, and we come back to the editor, and we have to choose, is it free, is it paid, is it private? For this video, I'm just going to make it free because I want to talk about the paid version in a future video. And let's go ahead and publish it. So you click on publish, prompt is published on our site. How do you know that? You can go to explore. You will be able to type in, for example, exercise and enter, and you should see the custom weekly exercise program for you prompt is now freely available. If somebody goes there and clicks on it, they will see this. They will see the sample results. They will be able to see the last result because that was public result, and they will be able to see their run history. They will be able to run it by clicking on the run. So that's it. You just publish the prompt. I highly recommend that you share the prompt with your social media on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook groups, or TikTok. Right here is the prompt URL. So this is the URL that you can post anywhere. If you want a short version of the URL, you can click on the tweet button and you can take a short URL, copy that, paste it, it's going to turn into the big URL. If you're SMSing, you might want to use the short version. So this is a very simple prompt app using a bunch of fields and not using any of our advanced features. Prompt engineering is new. This is why C Prompt is a social gamified platform to interact with each other and learn from each other. We have created many tools that allows you to interact with our users. As you hone your prompt engineering skills by creating prompt apps for your target market, you are also automatically enrolled into a AI certification program built into the C Prompt AI system. As you participate in the prompt creation and prompt ecosystem, the system is going to start qualifying you for various certificates. I'll talk about the certificates in another video. On C Prompt AI platform, you can do prompt engineering by creating prompt apps, interact with each other, throw a bounty, ask someone to create a prompt for you. If you don't know how to create a complicated prompt, throw a bounty, somebody can do it for you, discuss AI topics with each other, earn rewards from community chest every week. And don't forget, we also make it very easy to find external AI resources, very high qualified AI resources in our Who is Who section of the C Prompt AI platform. Please sign up today for free, showcase your AI skills, monetize your prompts, and earn a certificate or two. Be an early adopter, keep 90% of the fees that you earn, contribute 5% to the community chest. The platform only takes 5%, so join today at CPROMPT.AI. Thank you, and please like, share, and subscribe to this channel.